Welcome to PC Mac. Today we are talking about how we can install Android operating system on our Raspberry Pi 3 Model B. So let's do it. Before we start, I would like you to go ahead and click on the subscribe button. It's free and you can just go ahead and click on the bell icon for my latest videos. So let's get started. To start this practical, what we need is a Raspberry Pi 3 Model B. The second thing that we need is a SD card reader, and we need a 16 gig of memory card to install the operating system on our Raspberry Pi. So the first thing we need to do is to download the Android image for our Raspberry Pi. So let me go ahead and open the Google Chrome, and then here is the website. The name of the website is constakang.com. I'll provide you the link in the description, so you can go ahead and download the image from there. So the website is look like this. If you want to follow the developer, you can just go ahead and go to Twitter, his Twitter handle, and you can just follow him. Let me just go back, and we need to go into devices from here, and then we need to go on to Raspberry Pi 3. Just open it, and as you can see, here are the images. Lineage OS 15.1, that is Android 8.1.0, that is Oreo, that you can install on the Raspberry Pi 3. Let me just go ahead and open it, and let me just show you. So you can download the image from here. When you click on it, it will generate the mirrors from where you can download it. Let me just click on here, and it's searching for the mirrors. So as you can see, you can select the closest country, and the primary download is from here. So you can just select it and it will start downloading the image for you. I already downloaded the image, so let me take you to the image. So the image is right here. Let me just maximize the icons. So the OS is right here, Lineage OS. Let me just turn on the extensions. So it's a zip file, we need to extract it. So we need to use 7-zip to extract the image. So the image is successfully extracted here. We just open it and it will look something like this. Lineage 15.1 2018-0706, an official Constakang RPI3.img. Now we can write this image to a SD card and we can install it on our Raspberry Pi board. So to install this image, what we need to do is first of all download a software that is SD card formatter right here. So let me just show you the website as well. So here is the website. You just need to open it and you can download the tool from here by just going down, and for Windows you can click here, for Mac you can click here. Now once it's done, let me just insert my 16 gig of card to the computer to write the image, and as you can see, it automatically detects the card. Let me go ahead and format it. Now the card is successfully formatted. As you can see, format was completed, successfully completed. Let me click on OK and close this tool. Now to write this image to the SD card, we require one more tool. The name of the tool is Etcher. So here is the tool, etcher.io, and you can download it from right here. Download for Windows 64. Once you download it, it will look like this. So it will look like this. You just need to open it and it will open in a moment. From here we need to select the image. Let me go ahead and select my Lineage OS image, and now I need to select the drive, that is the G drive, USB 16 gig 15.72. continue, and I need to flash it. Now it will start flashing the image. We need to provide the permission and it will take some time. Now the image is successfully flashed on the SD card. What we need to do is close this boxes and take out the SD card and install it on the Raspberry Pi. Now I'm going to insert the SD card to my Raspberry Pi and we'll go ahead and turn it on. So as you can see, the Lineage OS is loading up now. It will show up in a moment. Now we're going to click on next and you can select your language. Then we need to select the time zone. You can just click on next. Here you can enable the location service, or you can just go ahead and uncheck that box to disable it. And here are some Lineage OS features. If there is any error, it will send it to the Lineage OS. Now we'll go ahead and protect our tablet with the pin. So we're going to set it up now. There are three methods to set up the protection for the tablet. Let me just go ahead and show you. Once I click on setup, it will show it to us. That is the pattern, pin and password. So I'll go with the pin because that's the easy one. Now I'm going to create the pin for my tablet, the Raspberry Pi tablet. Let's go ahead and do that. So the pin I'm creating now, it will be a 4-digit minimum. So it's created now. Let me just re-enter it again. Now it's done. Let's go ahead and move to the next step. So we'll skip this one and then we'll start our OS. So the OS will look like this. As you can see, the really nice interface of Lineage OS, and it will be loaded up like this. Let me just show you all the icons now by clicking on the up arrow, and it will take us directly to all the apps, and it will look like this. You can download the app from the third-party services. Let me just take you to the settings and create a user account to show you that we are able to connect to the internet or not, and we are able to sign up with our Gmail account or not on this tablet that we just created with the help of Raspberry Pi. So I'm just going to create my account. I'm using my old account. So you need to put your full email address here with @gmail.com. It will not take the half email address like the username. So I'm creating it. It will take a moment. So it's validating the server settings and I'm successfully logged in to my account, and I can easily go ahead and use my account now on this tablet. It asks you to put your username, so I put my name here and the account is successfully set up. As you can see, we have received a mail as well for the security purpose that I have been logged in with the new account. I received that email on my phone as well. So this is this whole setup look like. You can go ahead and do it by yourself on your computer, on your Raspberry Pi, and let me know in the comment section. And you can use F5 to turn off this tablet. If you like my video, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel and give us a thumbs up so I can make the video in future as well. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.